Hello, everyone. Hillary Clinton is speaking out to our own Anderson Cooper after releasing her book, What Happened. In it, she ultimately blames herself for the 2016 presidential election loss. Here's one excerpt. I go back over my own shortcomings and the mistakes we made. I take responsibility for all of them. You can blame the data, blame the message, blame anything you want, but I was the candidate. Well, during her interview with Anderson, she also spread around the blame to lots of different people, including former FBI director James Comey.
You said about Jim Comey that he shivved you.
Yes.
Which is a very, that's a strong word.
It is a strong word.
And it also implies that this was a personal or that he was trying to get you.
He's never been clear about his motivation. And what bothered me the most as the time went on after the election is, and we learned more about the open FBI investigation into the Trump campaign and their connections with Russia. That had been going on for quite some time. The American people didn't know about it. He was specifically asked, why didn't you tell the American people about that investigation? And he said, well, because it was too close to an election. So ask yourself, a closed investigation that ended the prior July, an ongoing investigation into the Trump campaign and Russia, one deserves to be blown out of all proportion, nothing to be found one more time, and the American people don't have the information that there's a legitimate investigation going on about Trump and Russia before they vote. But, you know, what's important to me going forward is, as I say, I think it's important to focus on what happened because lessons can be learned. But the more important lessons that will affect our democracy going forward are not about him and his investigation. He, I think, forever changed history, but that's in the past. What's important is the fact that the Russians are still going at us. He himself admitted that before Congress.
Peter Matthews joins me now. He's a political analyst and professor of political science at Cyprus College. Peter, always good to have you with us.
Good to be here, Aisha.
It does seem as if, at least on this issue, Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump are on the same page when it comes to Comey, that he's been a bit of a pain for both of them.
For both of them. Isn't that remarkable, right? And she's told all about it in her book. Very interesting. Brought up certain issues and ideas which I can identify with because I ran for Congress back in 1998, won the primary, lost the general by a few percent of the vote. And it's quite a letdown. And she ran for the presidency, which is just so much larger.
Yeah.
And people were expecting her to win, right? Most people, and she was certainly. And she's going back and looking, rehashing and seeing what mistakes she may have made along the way. And then she's also trying to get a larger lesson for all of us about letting possibly a foreign government get involved in our democracy. And she's trying to draw larger lessons besides her own pain and suffering from losing.
So, I think she would make that clear that, you know, it's about what it means for democracy and the future course for this country.
Yes.
That's also what's being tackled in this book. You know, the White House Press Secretary, Sarah Sanders, has spent the last 3 days calling James Comey's credibility into question. And in some ways, that's what Hillary Clinton is doing also. What were his motivations for the way he handled the email server investigation?
Yeah.
My question to you is, how closely will Mueller be following the special counsel investigator? How closely will he be following the words of Hillary Clinton as she too brings up these questions about Comey?
I think he'll be following it closely because it's definitely tied into the whole picture, isn't it? And I believe that he's looking for any kind of insight that he could get, insight in his investigation of the Trump campaign or of other investigations that he's actually conducting. And he wants to see what this book is about that could actually open things up for him, possibly.
Mm-hmm.
He won't rely on it entirely, but he's certainly paying attention to it, I'm sure, to some extent.
Well, you know, Hillary Clinton does accept responsibility, as we made clear, and we read that excerpt, but she does go on to, you know, share the blame with a lot of people.
Yes, she does.
including James Comey, as we just said. Russia gets some of it.
Yes.
White women get some of it. White men get some of it. Bernie Sanders.
I mean, don't forget that. There's
a list here.
Yes.
I guess that's to be expected, that in this kind of situation, you know, she doesn't feel she's the only one here that was in the wrong. But you're a student of political science. Do you feel the Democratic Party will take this narrative that she's putting out here and say, oh, well, it wasn't our fault that we lost the election, and will actually absolve themselves of the work they need to do to capture large segments of the population?
That's the danger, Aisha. If they do that, they're going to fail again. They should really take responsibility for what happened with the election and their shortcomings and her shortcomings, and then go forward with a positive message about what the party stands for. They have to rebuild the message, the ideological platform of the party, and they're trying to decide now whether to go the route that Bernie Sanders projected or a more moderate route, which I think Bernie's is quite progressive, but at the same time it's acceptable by many American people, but they're trying to decide which way should the party go. And they better get it together soon and come up with specific ideological ideas and issues that they stand for and come up with a positive agenda, or they're going to lose if they start blaming and saying, well, it wasn't our fault.
Yeah.
You know, next time the Russians won't be around, or maybe they'll be around. That's just diverting from what the American people really want and need for their own benefit to make the country better.
I mean, this really is a watershed moment for the Democratic Party, right?
Yes, it is. It really does. And many parties, once in a while, they go through soul searching. It doesn't happen very often, and this is the time they have to do it. And I think with leaders such as Bernie Sanders, Elizabeth Warren, and others who are coming aboard now, and today, in fact, Bernie introduced his single-payer health care plan, which was a remarkable first, wasn't it? Mm-hmm. And he had 15 or 16 co-sponsors in the Senate of other senators, which is very remarkable. It wouldn't have happened had not Bernie pushed that throughout the campaign, and Hillary actually ended up adopting it.
Yeah.
So the party has to decide what it really believes in, what it can inspire American people with, and go back in a way to learn from President Roosevelt, how he had a vision for the party, and that's why he was so successful four times, and so was the party at that time.
Yeah. Last question for you. There's been a lot of schmoozing at the White House between the president yes. and Democratic leaders.
Quite remarkable.
And now we're hearing that Wednesday night another deal has been done. At least we're hearing from Dems saying that there is a deal in place to get a new DREAMer, a bipartisan DREAM Act that would protect those young people who were brought to this country illegally as young people from being deported.
Yes.
And they say there's a deal on the table and it will involve some border security, but not the wall. Sarah Sanders, the White House Secretary, is pushing back about this issue, whether the wall's on the table or not. More importantly, if there is a deal, mm-hmm. how is this going to go over on Capitol Hill with Republicans?
Not very well, because they've been, to them, it's anathema that he's going to go ahead. Well, some Republicans are for giving the Dreamers a chance to stay in America and work as Obama had let them do. Other Republicans are totally against it, and their base is against it. That's the problem. And Trump's own base was totally against the Dreamers staying here, or anyone staying here illegally.
And he campaigned
and to build
on
the wall.
That.
And
he said on the first day.
It was
you know?
A major part of his platform, wasn't it? So it's going to cost him some support either way. The question is, which of the two is the largest support that will drop off? And unfortunately, we shouldn't even be talking about these things, about tactics. It's really the essence of the issue. Should these young people be allowed to stay here in a country, the only one they've ever known before? And they're exemplary children, young people who are actually going to college, many of them. They're achieving, high achievers, and they deserve a chance to stay. So I think that's why Trump saw there was a lot of pushback against him for looking like he's going to put them down and let them completely on their own.
Mm.
So it's going to be very interesting to see what happens now.
We shall watch closely, see what happens in the coming hours. Peter Matthews, always a pleasure. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you.